Cindy McCain, back on the national stage, back on morning television, and very much back on script.
I'm a mother, I'm a business owner, I'm a grandmother, and I want a president who has my back on things, and someone who is, would have my back as a citizen and someone who lives in a neighborhood and has a family and all the other things that people do.
The widow of John McCain, a long-term Republican senator and one-time Republican presidential nominee, Cindy McCain, with a full-hearted endorsement of Democrat Joe Biden.
I want to feel like my president cares about me and cares about this country, and Joe Biden does.
The McCains are royalty in Arizona, a key state in 2020, and Cindy McCain is already targeting a key block of voters.
I'm hoping that I can encourage suburban women to take another look and take a, you know, women that are particularly on the fence and, you know, are unhappy with what's going on right now, but also are not sure they want to cross the line and vote for Joe. I hope they'll take a look at what I believe and will move forward and come with me and join the Team Biden and vote for Biden.
I have to ask you, Mrs. McCain.
The president tweeting, "I hardly know Cindy McCain," other than having put her on a committee at her husband's request. Joe Biden was John McCain's lapdog. So many bad decisions on endless wars and the VA, which I brought from a horror show to high approval. Never a fan of John, Cindy can have Sleepy Joe.
As you might imagine, this is drawn a response from President Trump just minutes ago. It's just coming in right now. He sent out a tweet. He said, "Never a fan of John, Cindy can have Sleepy Joe." Your response?
I don't have any.
In 2016, John McCain received 1.36 million votes in Arizona for his Senate seat, more than 100,000 more votes than Donald Trump at the top of the ticket. But the president comfortably carried the silver state and is confident again this time. It's the latest escalation between the president and the McCains.
I endorsed him at his request, and I gave him the kind of funeral that he wanted, which as president, I had to approve. I don't care about this. I didn't get thank you. That's okay. We sent him on the way, but I wasn't a fan of John McCain.
And an escalation of the surprise friendship between the McCains and the Bidens. In 2018, Joe Biden gave the eulogy for the man he ran against a decade earlier.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democrat. And I love John McCain. I have had the dubious honor over the years of giving some eulogies for fine women and men that I've admired. But Lindsay, this one's hard.
In an era where several notable Republicans have endorsed the Democratic challenger, Cindy McCain's might be the most surprising and most impactful of them all.